I'm backstage at Bloodstock 2011. Napalm Death are kicking serious ass on the stage right now, and I'm with the lovely guys from Hell. How was today, guys?
Fantastic. Great turnout, great show. We loved it.
It's absolutely amazing. At that time of the morning, the people would actually get up and make an effort to be there at 11 o'clock in the morning.
You were there to clean out the cobwebs.
I think so, and I think we may have just done that.
I heard the crowd, they sounded amazing.
Yeah, well, they were absolutely fantastic. I mean, from our point of view, as an opening band, you really don't know quite what to expect. I mean, the last day of a festival, is everybody still hungover from the night before, which was a great day yesterday, or are they actually going to get up and come and give us a bit of a support? And they went for it. Absolutely awesome.
You've been in the industry, you started in 82, so almost 30 years, and you've just got kind of back together, and you did with the new lineup a gig in Nottingham in May. How was it getting back together and kind of doing it live again after such a long time?
It was cathartic. It was very strange. From my perspective, I've not played for 15 years. While we were building the stuff together, and then there was the period where we were producing the album, and I was playing with a broken arm as well, which is still broken, and it's repairing. So that aside, the question is how did it feel? It was absolutely, it was just amazing. It was surreal, wasn't it?
Yeah. It was almost tearful,
because it was like all your buddies back together again, and it was just good fun.
Imagine a kid that gets a big box of Lego for Christmas. Yeah, well, we got some new guitars and we went out and played with our toys. As simple as that. It was like walking out on stage, it literally brought you. My wife said to me when I got home, "You look 10 years younger." I was like, "Okay, I need to do another one of them then."
Because you've just put together the album Human Remains, which went in actually really high in the charts in Germany. What's the reception been on the tour that you've been on so far?
Fantastic. I mean, all over Europe, it's been incredible. Apparently, we charted actually in Finland, in Sweden, in Germany and in France, which is incredible. And we're selling really well in Japan. So, I mean, for a bunch of old guys that have made this comeback, it's just unbelievable. It's a fairy tale. That's all I can say. It's amazing.
Any thoughts on that?
Same as his, really.
You initially were described as a new wave of British heavy metal. Would you categorise yourself in that genre?
I think we'd like to come over as the transition between the new wave of British heavy metal and the modern gear. We've tried to be in between. I mean, the songs were written in the early 80s, so they're going to sound that way, because when they were written, obviously we were influenced by bands that we were into at the time. So they are going to come across a little bit that way. The vocals are clear, there's not the growly sort of stuff that the modern bands have. So it's always going to be categorised that way. But as long as people buy the album, call us what they want.
Yeah, I think it's also been, it's a modern treatment, but it's been a sympathetic treatment of what Andy Sneap has done. It's actually amazing in the whole process, hasn't he? Because obviously Andy was a big follower of the band when he was like 13 years of age. I can still see him now sitting around on Dave Halliday's sofa, the original vocalist who fortunately took his life, and this snotty little kid, little Oik, learning guitar. And it's amazing to have him on stage with us now, filling that gap.
Well, he's got quite a massive reputation as a producer. He's worked with loads of bands, Napalm Death, Testament, Creator, all the bands I love and adore. So has that been a factor in when you were making the new album as well? Did it come into play?
What you got to remember is we know Andy as Andy, not Andy Sneap, this god in the production world. Andy to us is as a friend, as a mate. When he got us all together, it wasn't a case of, oh God, we're at Andy's house. It's a case of, hey, let's have a curry, let's get some beer, let's have some fun. Because if we started to think of Andy like that, it would become Andy's band. And that's really not what it's all about. This is Hell. This is Andy, if you like, using the tools he's got at his disposal to help us out and bring the band to where it is. Yeah, I mean, we've used it. But Andy is Andy. He's a friend of ours. He's not... I don't know.
You know him as a 13-year-old kid.
Yeah.
He's not up there. We remember him. We bring him down on that front. Yeah.
It's got to be done.
He's as daft as we are.
So what's coming up next for you guys? You've got a couple more tour dates, I believe.
We're in Germany on Wednesday at the Summer Breeze Festival, which is a label day for Nuclear Blast. Early September, we're headlining a festival in Dublin, The Pint, which should be a good one. Then we've got the Sweden Rock Cruise, which is going to get kind of messy because we've got to go straight to Athens after that. How we're all going to get off the boat and get on a plane and get to Athens, I don't know, but Wilson.
Booze. Lots of.
Oh no, we'll just drink tea and
I have
play Scrabble.
No sea legs at all, so I can sort of come out on the channel and just sit there bobbing, and I'm throwing up. So that should be.
Maybe you have to do the Mr. T milk thing that they used to do to Mr. T in the A team.
Knock him out.
Yeah,
maybe.
I think we'll probably be knocked out anyway. We should have wake up. Is that the Coliseum? Who put that there?
I'm not convinced. I think I need medication of some description. I think you're right.
So are you staying here for the rest of the festival today?
Oh yeah.
We're on the beer now.
Maybe.
Is there any bands today that you want to check out?
Yeah, obviously Motorhead, because they're the same era as us, and I mean they're a band that we've grown. They're legends to us. But quite a few of the other bands, Exodus, good friends, Hammerfall, a band I've not seen. I'd love to see them. Somewhere.
They're on next.
Yeah, I'm going to have to rush off in a minute. Come on, hurry up.
And I'd say I probably concur, but I couldn't be here yesterday because we were doing some last minute rehearsals because Andy had just come back from San Francisco. So Tony gets to go away. So I've got two guitars and drums and a set of keyboards blasting through my ears. And I wanted to see Winter Sun yesterday, but I didn't get the opportunity. But good friends of ours.
Yeah, we had a good time. Sorry.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah.
Like I saw I picked you up this morning. I know exactly what you look like this morning.
We won't go into that one.
Well, after that note, enjoy the beers today. I'll be catching up with you later on for a couple. And enjoy the festival. Thank you very much, guys.
Take care, Rob. Thanks.